Hello and welcome to the final part of pulling the perfect key in Avid with me, Ben Brownlee from Boris FX. So as you've made it this far, you'll have a firm grasp of the steps that I go through to build up a key. Once we're at this section, we can start looking at details. And some of the details that I want to focus on here are going to be, let's just zoom over here a little bit. They're going to be sort of edge details about how we deal with color right within the edges of our image. And as we can see down here as well, maybe having a look at what we're doing with the edges there to try and get that to sit in a little bit easier, a little bit better. And then the final thing is to unify it. So whether that's glow or some type of color correction effect or sorting out the grain, I just like to unify everything together right at the very end. So let's focus now on edges first. And I'm going to turn off a couple of these things. I'm going to mute my particle illusion clip. I'm just going to mute my lens flare for the moment being as well, so I can focus a bit more on my nave clip. Let's come back into our effect editor and back into Primatte Studio. All right, so we have looked through a lot of these controls. We haven't used all of them because we haven't needed to. So before we come to the meat and potatoes of this exercise, I'll just polish up a couple of the ones we've skipped over. So we've got adjust light. This is a really useful one for when we have an uneven background. We didn't need it in this case. We were able to pull everything together with our regular controls, which was fantastic. And we also have matte refinement. Now I've left this off as well because, oh well, as I was playing with this a bit earlier, wasn't I? We were sort of coming in and affecting some of the stuff with the detailed edges there when we were doing spill suppression. So we can use things like choke just to choke in or extend out some of the details we were missing. But generally speaking, if we've got a lot of details, we want to be very, very careful with using too much matte refinement. If you've got a much calmer hairdo, something very flat, which is also going with some very flat, well-defined edges on your clothing, we can actually use this a little bit more just to soften out the edges just a tiny bit, soften those inwards a tiny bit, as we can see down here. But I don't want to use this on this particular clip because we have too much other stuff going on with the hair that is going to just ruin the effect a little bit there. Okay, so I'm going to leave matte refinement off because we don't need it for this shot. And I'm going to come down now to what I really want to talk about, which is Lightwrap and edge color correction. Great. So let's zoom in here and use the old Control and Alt or Command and Option to pan around the viewer. And let's look at Lightwrap. And I'm going to look at Lightwrap edge first. And I'm going to turn that on and I'll open this up. And it says the wrap source is going to be the background layer. We have a choice of using either the background layer, which we define up at the top here, or using a color solid. Now I'm going to define my background layer as two below, or second below, because I've got this filler layer underneath. So that would just be choosing the filler layer, and the filler layer, which is my lens flare, I do believe. So we don't want that. So background, second below. And what the Lightwrap does is it takes the pixel values or the color values from this background layer and softly brings those over the top of my image. So if I open up my UI and just go Lightwrap on black, you can see what it's doing. It's taking those edge details, let's bring it over there, and taking the colors from my background clip and placing those over the top. And we can choose how this works. Let's go back into my final composite. So we can change things like the softness, the lightness, and the width. And probably most importantly here, we can change the apply mode. And we have all the regular apply modes we have across the Continuum series of plugins. So in, if we want to make things a little bit brighter, we can use a screen. Or if we want to make things a lot brighter, we can use the add. Or if we want to darken things down, we can use things like darken, darker, multiply, or subtract. We also have soft light, which is a kind of nice middle ground as well, sort of combination depending on the darker or lighter pixels. I can just maybe touch the brightness up on that a little bit there as well. So we can see Lightwrap off. and Lightwrap on. Check it out just at the bottom down here. Let's zoom over to the other side. Lightwrap off and Lightwrap on. Show you where we've got something a little bit more wild to look at. Now here, because we've got quite a dark background, if I put this to something like screen or add and keep everything at 100%, it's going to be very obvious what we've done. It's actually just going to highlight the fact that we've got a composite going on all around the edge there, rather than hide that fact. So we can be a bit subtle about things. And we do have a mix with original, if we wanted to bring this back a little bit as well. But, you know, because this is quite a subtle effect already, the way I've got it set up, you know, it's mixed with original is not going to do too much. But actually, I'm going to turn Lightwrap Edge off completely. And I like this new feature that we have in the 2020 version of Primatte Studio, which is the Lightwrap Spill. So what this does is it again lets us look at the background layer or a solid layer and use that same Lightwrap idea, Lightwrap technology, but it applies it to the spill only. And in this way, we can get some very natural looking color going around our spill and our edges. Zoom in. Come over here to our hair. And you see just by lightening or darkening that up, we can mix in some of that into the spill. It's just a very subtle way, if I turn that on and off, very subtle way of just bringing those colors right back in from the background into our composite. It's fantastic. Love it. And again, we can mix this back as well. Sort of see a before and after. Just mix that with the original spill. Another one we have is edge color correction. So this is, as it, you know, kind of leads you to believe, it's color correction that only happens on the edge. I'll zoom out one more time. And this actually used to be really important for times when the original spill suppressor wasn't able to quite capture all of those green details around the hair. We could come in and we could, you know, retint some of the edge, just to kind of, you know, mix that back. Let's bring the edge up a little bit so you can really see that happening. Check out what's happening on the edge. Lovely. You know, and you would sort of manually bring that in to figure out what was going on. Now, of course, we've got the secondary spill remover, which works an absolute treat. So I haven't had to use this technique ever since 2020 came out. But that doesn't preclude us from being able to just come in and do stuff with the edge if we want to still. If we wanted to have a little bit more, like bring that rim light up a little bit more, we could easily sort of just enhance that with a thin edge, a little bit of gamma there. If we wanted to take that away, we could take the gamma down and blend that into the background just a little bit more. We've got the before and the after. We'll zoom in so you can see that a little bit better through the compression that we've got before and after. You can get this as sort of wild and crazy as you want to, or just, you know, a nice subtle effect just to help smoothly sell that composite. Cool, so I'm happy with my edges now. And it's just a couple of very small things, but they do have quite a big effect on the clip as a whole. All right, so let's unmute our clips here and here. Bring this back in. And just while we're here, because we're in Avid, we've got the geometrics at the bottom of, you know, a lot of our effects. So it's a great way of being able to reposition our effect in the scene. Obviously, it looks a little bit weird here, and that's because we've got geometrics on pre-apply. So it means we're moving it before it's applied any of the other effects. And obviously, because we have our mats that we've created in Mocha, applying there, we actually want to apply this post effect. And now we can move this around and it'll work exactly as we want it to. Okay, absolute final thing that we're going to do is just put a quick color correction over the top of everything. And for this, just to show you the idea behind it, I'm going to come into my film style and take fast film process. I will use Control or Command Y again, just to create another layer over the top. Bring over my fast film process. Come into the effects browser. And let's find something that's going to work for us. Kind of like the color reversal film. What else we got? Well, the saturation boost is also quite nice. Yeah, let's use a saturation boost. Just to bring everything together. We'll bypass before and after. That's looking quite nice. Should we do anything else with this? Yeah, okay. I'm going to add in a fast film glow over the top. So I'm going to alt-click or alt-drag over the top of my filler there and come into my effect editor. Bring the glow intensity up so we can see what it's doing. Bring the glow radius up so we can see what that's doing. And then take the threshold up so we're only applying it to the brightest areas. And then take my intensity back down again and apply that there so we can see the final result. Cool, I'm going to render that out and see what we've got. And if we take a look at this now, we can see we're in a pretty interesting place, especially when you consider where it is we started. And this is probably a more detailed clip than a lot of the things that that I work on, but the ideas are always still the same. And it's important just to recognize the process and build up those steps as you go along, but only building up the ones that you actually need to get the result that you need. For example, just a straightforward Talking Heads interview probably doesn't need a lot of particles over the top of it or a lot of lens flare behind it, but the key idea is about looking at Primatte Studio and using the modules that you need to get the work done. And the fact that you've got all of these tools, the Kia, the Spill Remover, the built-in Mocha, the built-in Color Corrector, the built-in Lightwrap, and not least the built-in Geometrics, all within that one filter means that it's a lot easier to kind of keep control over the effect. And if you've got multiple shots that use the same sort of lighting, the same sort of background, you can, of course, save all of this stuff out as a preset. So you don't have to do all of your work again and again and again. You can just come in and use that as a template and sort of work fast and move on very quickly. And I'm going to leave you now, but I hope that's been useful for you as we've gone through the different stages of building up this key, including the primary key, the spill suppression, enhancing our mattes with hold-in and hold-out masks, doing a primary balance between foreground and background, adding additional elements in front and behind the subject, and then finally looking at edges and overall color balance to end up with our final shot. Thanks very much for joining me in this series. My name is Ben Brownlee from Boris FX, and I hope to see you in another tutorial series in the near future. Thanks for now. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, consider hitting the thumbs up button as well. That like really makes a difference. To find out the latest news about Primatte Studio, Continuum, and all of the Boris FX products, then be sure to visit borisfx.com.